I'm hosting a little party here today at the Chocolate Festival. I've wandered around, I've sampled more than my fair share of chocolates, and I've chosen my top five. And I've explained to a group of journalists why I've fallen in love with the ones I have.
Chocolate isn't already hedonistic enough. What we decided to do this evening is to pair some chocolate with some different drinks. So I'm doing a special tasting of five chocolates from different chocolatiers who are here at the festival. And with them, I've specifically matched a different drink with each one. So it should be a good night.
I'm Sophie Ray from the Lush Spa team. Two of our spa treatments actually feature chocolate quite heavily, so that's really what we're showcasing today.
I'm Martin Christie and I run a website called 70%, which is all about tasting and appreciating fine chocolate. So we're here with the Direct Cacao Zone. But in Direct Cacao, we're really promoting the idea you get better tasting chocolate that's better for you and it's better for the farmer. Farmers get paid a much higher price with this direct relationship between the chocolate maker and the cacao grower.
Hi, I'm Pablo from Forever Cacao. I make a raw, unroasted chocolate bars. I source my beans directly from an indigenous people in Peru called the Ashaninka people. They only produce a small amount of beans in a global scale, and then I start the process of converting them from beans into chocolate bars, keeping everything unroasted and as raw and as natural as possible to keep all the health benefits and all the antioxidants available to you. So it's healthy chocolate.
I'm absolutely thrilled to bits with my little Christmas trees here. Gold with some specks of glitter made out of our own milk chocolate, but also my little joys, I call them my gems. These are my little tea and coffee cups. They're all individually hand-painted, filled with different caramels from teas and coffees, such as Viennese coffee with fig, or chai tea, or even Earl Grey, tea that is grown in Cornwall. It's a little bit of Britishness, really, we need to have it.